ম্যাথ ভিশন ইউর এডুকেশনাল ফ্রেন্ড। স্কুল লেভেলে এখানে পড়ানো হচ্ছে ক্লাস ফাইভ থেকে ক্লাস টুয়েলভ পর্যন্ত, বোর্ড, সিবিএসই, আইসিএসই, আইএসসি, ওয়েস্ট বেঙ্গল। সাবজেক্ট হল ম্যাথমেটিক্স, ফিজিক্স, কেমিস্ট্রি, বায়োলজি, কম্পিউটার। কলেজ লেভেলে এখানে পড়ানো হচ্ছে বিএসসি পাস কোর্স, ইঞ্জিনিয়ারিং, বিসিএ, বিবিএ, পলিটেকনিক। রয়েছে এন্ট্রান্সের প্রিপারেশন, জেইই, আইআইটি, জেক্সপো, ভোকোলেট, জেইএলএফটি অ্যান্ড কম্পিটিটিভ এক্সাম, আইবিপিএস, ব্যাঙ্ক, রেল, এসএসসি জেনারেল, ডব্লিউবিসিএস, পিএসসি। সেন্টার শিলিগুড়িতে সুভাষপল্লী শালুগড়া, আলিপুরদুয়ারে নিউ টাউন, জলপাইগুড়িতে কদমতলা। যোগাযোগ করুন এই ফোন নম্বরে 9832489384, 7001046336।
প্রথমে ডিসকাস করবো আজকে, তো টিস্যু সম্পর্কে ডিসকাস করার আগে প্রথমে আমরা সেল নিয়ে প্রথমে স্টার্ট করি। খুব বেসিক ইনফরমেশন, যেমন আমরা জানি দ্য সেল ইজ দ্য বেসিক ফান্ডামেন্টাল ইউনিট, আই মিন ফাংশনাল স্ট্রাকচারাল অ্যান্ড ফাংশনাল ইউনিট অফ লাইফ অর অফ অ্যান অর্গানিজম ইজ দ্য সেল। স্ট্রাকচারাল অর্গানাইজেশন বিকজ সেলস দে ফর্ম ultimately the tissues, and tissues ultimately form the organ and organ system, and depending on the functioning of the organ system, the whole life that continues. So this is a structural unit, functional unit, because all the functioning of an organ that takes place inside the cell, for example kidney filtrates our blood, it purify blood. It means kidney purifying blood, it means that each and every cell of my kidney is playing important role in the purification of the blood. Like heart is pumping the blood, lungs helps in breathing, so it means that my cardiac cells or my lung cells, each and every of my cell are contributing their role in the functioning of the whole organ. That's why this is also known as the fundamental functional unit also of the life or organism. Now a cell consists of, first of all, if it is a plant cell, then outermost layer is the cell wall, and if it is animal cell, the outermost layer is the cell membrane. Plant cell, outermost layer is the cell wall, and second layer is the cell membrane. In animal cell, there is no cell wall, the outermost layer is the cell membrane. Cell wall also always give a tough structure, that's why plants, they have cell wall. Animals, they don't have cell wall, they are plasma membrane or cell membrane as the outermost layer. Now the cell membrane is important here because it is all known as the semi-permeable membrane of the organism or the cell. Semi-permeable membrane means all the substances cannot pass through the cell membrane or plasma membrane. Some selective substances can only pass through. That's why selectively permeable or semi-permeable membrane. Then next, if I enter into the cell, first I will see the cytoplasm, then I will see the nucleus and other cell organelles. Cytoplasm, we know cytoplasm is the medium in the cell where all the cell organelles are found. So if it is asked what is the function of cytoplasm in the cell, we will say that all the metabolic activities of the cell that takes place in the cytoplasm. And then the nucleus is the, we can say it is the headquarter of the cell. I mean, it nucleus controls everything, what will be the structure of the cell, shape of the cell, the functioning of the cell, everything depends on the cell. When it will divide, when it will not divide, what is the lifespan of the cell, okay, when it will stop functioning, everything is controlled by our nucleus. How? Because nucleus, first of all, if we look at the nucleus, we will see that it is also membranous. I mean, eukaryotic, particularly eukaryotes. There are two terms, eukaryotes and prokaryotic organisms in this world. Eukaryotes means we are eukaryotes. Okay, plants are eukaryotes, means they have a proper well-defined nucleus. It means that we have a proper nuclear membrane, where prokaryotic organisms, they do not have any nuclear membrane. Now in this nucleus, what is present? Genetic substances or genetic materials are present. Genetic substances means particularly talking about DNA, RNA, all these substances, all are genetic substances. And genes which are located inside the DNA. So genes or the DNA, they are expressing all the functioning of the cell. Okay, now this nucleus also, we see some kind of substance, fluid medium present inside the nucleus, which is known as nucleoplasm. Outside of nucleoplasm, it is a cytoplasm. So cytoplasm plus nucleoplasm known as protoplasm. So now we will see the other cell organelles in the cytoplasm. For example, like mitochondria, Golgi body, centrioles, okay, then endoplasmic reticulum, vacuoles, okay, all different types of cell organelles are present. But there are some differences between plant and animal cell. Like vacuole basically presents in the plant cell and it is of big size, large size. Animal cells, they do not have vacuole. If it is there, so it's a very small size vacuoles. Then plastids. Plastids are absent in the animal cell, it is present in the plant cell. Centrioles are also present in the animal cell, it is absent in the plant cell. Let's look into the functioning little bit. Mitochondria, we know that it is known as the powerhouse of the cell because it produces energy, that is ATP. How it produces ATP? With the help of, there are two functioning which are directly indirectly involved in the production of energy from the mitochondria. Mitochondria is common. Okay, digestion and respiration, these are the two processes which are directly or indirectly involved in the production of energy from the mitochondria. Digestion, why? Digestion, it ultimately all the nutrients are extracted from the food components by the process of digestion, and that is absorbed in the stomach few and mostly from the small intestine, and those nutrients then goes to all the cells of the body. First is goes to the liver cell, and from the liver it distributes to all the body, all the cells. Out of this, all these nutrients, carbohydrate is of the first preference for production of energy. Second preference is protein and then fat. Okay, so carbohydrates are the energy provider. So carbohydrate now is now present in the cell. Now next is what? Respiration, the breathing. Through breathing, oxygen enters in the cell through RBC, and this oxygen goes in the cell, it breaks down the carbohydrate and energy is released in the form of ATP. It means that digestion and respiration both are involved in the production of energy from mitochondria. Next, one more thing, it is so important function that is controlled by mitochondria, energy production, because life exists because of energy, and that is why mitochondria have its own DNA. Okay, when that nucleus has its DNA which controls everything, mitochondria is a cell organelle which also has its own DNA which control its functioning. One more cell organelle which is having its own DNA, it is the chloroplast, that is present in the plant cell. Okay, because that is the organ in the plant cell which helps in the production of food by photosynthesis. So it is also important. Next is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum, there are two types, smooth endoplasmic and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Rough, why? Because on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum there are ribosomes. So ribosome is another type of cell organelle which is present on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, which makes it rough. And smooth means there we cannot see any ribosomes. So why ribosome exist with endoplasmic reticulum? There is a reason behind it. Ribosome is the site for protein synthesis. In some book it is written that endoplasmic reticulum where the protein synthesis takes place, but it is not exactly. It is the ribosome which is present on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, okay, where protein synthesis takes place. And then the protein enters into the endoplasmic reticulum, okay, and function of endoplasmic reticulum here is to transport packaging means modifications in the protein substance, and then transport of the protein substance within the cell and one cell to another cell. This is the functioning of the endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus both. Apart from this Golgi body or Golgi apparatus, one more function is that they also involve in the production of lipids in the cell, means fats in the cell. Okay, centrioles, we know that centrioles have a very important role in cell division, because when the chromosomes during cell division supposed to divide equally, Okay, so that division of chromosomes equally is done by the centriole, because centrioles, they produce spindle fibers around them, and the spindle fibers attach to the centromere of the chromatids, and then there are two centrioles on both the poles of the cell, and they drag the chromosomes equally to both the poles, and this is how the one cell divides into two new cell with equal number of chromosomes. This is the function of centriole. So that's I think we have also discussed one day that there is always a checkpoint present, that is called metaphase checkpoint, where it is checked that whether the spindle fibers are properly attached to the centromere or not. If it is not attached, there will be unequal distribution of chromosomes, and that will be leading to many kind of disorders, like we have discussed, like Down syndrome, Klinefelter's, Turner's, okay, which may lead to genetic disorder, which may transmit even from generation to generation. So it is very important. Centriole's role is very important during cell division. So these are the some basic cell organelles. Now let's go into the tissues. Cells, they combine together and they form tissues. Now let's talk about the plant tissues today. Basically, plant tissues, if we divide them like temporary and there are some permanent tissues, meristematic tissues and permanent tissues. Meristematic tissues means the meaning of meristematic is temporary, means the cells which divide continuously. So wherever there is cell division, it will grow obviously that region. So where are these located? In the tip of the root, in the tip of the shoot, means that in the tip of the stem or branch it may be, where cell division continues, and that part obviously keep on growing because cell division is going on. So those are the meristematic areas. The cells are called meristematic cells, which keeps on dividing. Now permanent means the time comes when the cell stops dividing, they are not going to divide anymore, permanent. Okay, now simple tissues are like parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma. They are the simple plant tissues. Parenchyma cells, if I see the structural difference, because functionally almost they are same, because if I give the functioning of parenchyma, sclerenchyma and collenchyma, it is the structural support, which is called mechanical support to the plant. Second is that storage of food, secretions of some substances, and also most importantly photosynthesis do takes place, particularly in the parenchyma cells. Parenchyma cell structure, if I say that the cell wall is very thin and it is made up of cellulose, which is a polysaccharide, it's a complex form of carbohydrate. Okay, the cell arrangement, intercellular gaps we will see in between the parenchyma cells, and then the collenchyma. And one more thing, the parenchyma cells which are involved in photosynthesis, they are called chlorenchyma. The spelling I would like to mention is CHLOREN, chlorenchyma. Because why I am spelling this, because there is a one more second tissue, is the collenchyma. So collenchyma and chlorenchyma, you must know the difference. Collenchyma is another type of simple tissue which is definitely not parenchyma cell. Okay, collenchyma, if I see the structure, the cell wall is comparatively thicker than the parenchyma cells. It is made up of cellulose and pectin. So one addition, pectin is also there, which is again a complex polysaccharide. Now the arrangement of cells is very compact, comparatively compact. Intercellular gaps are almost less, there is no gaps. And then third is the sclerenchyma, which is basically a dead cell. The cell wall, we know that it is lignified. Lignified means it is made up of lignin, L-I-G-N-I-N. It is again a complex form of polysaccharide. It is a most complex form of carbohydrate, lignin. So which gives the toughest structure to the cell body. So that is the sclerenchyma. Now let's go into the complex tissues. Complex tissues are which are actually vascular tissues or conductive tissues, like xylem and phloem. These are permanent. Okay, then there is no more cell division. So xylem tissue, phloem tissue, we all know the functioning of all these things. There are four different types of xylem tissues: tracheids, facials, xylem fiber and xylem parenchyma. Basically xylem tissue is dead. All the tissues are dead except xylem parenchyma. Phloem tissues are like sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem fiber and phloem parenchyma. Phloem tissues are basically living cells except phloem fiber. So this is a difference between xylem and phloem. Functional also we know that xylem that helps in transportation of mineral and water from the root to the all the green parts of the plant. It's not that only to the leaves, because we used to say that it is the leaf where photosynthesis takes place, because most of the green parts in the plant is the leaf, are the leaves. That's why it's okay. We say that it is the leaves where photosynthesis takes place, but it's not exactly. Technically, if we say that all the green parts of the plant where photosynthesis takes place. So xylem transport minerals and water to all parts which are green. Phloem, opposite. Phloem helps in distribution of the food which are made in those parts to all the cells. Okay, this is a basic difference between xylem and phloem. Okay, I think let's my colleague teachers, let's move on if you want to some other topics.
Just some word on lysosome.
Lysosomes are also, lysosomes are actually present in the plants, animal cell, which is known as called suicide bag. Suicide bag, because it is, you know, what happens is that it's like what is it, defending the body. Means if any organisms enter into the cell, what happens is that there is a process called phagocytosis. It moves to the particular microorganism. If it is bacteria, for example, it moves towards that and it, you know, engulfs the bacteria inside it, inside that structure. And lysosome is filled with all the enzymes, and the enzyme helps in killing the germs. The killing process is, it's not that it killing inside it. The lysosome whole itself bursts, damaged, with the help of enzymes. So what happens, whatever is present inside it, the harmful germ, bacteria and all, also get damaged. That's a suicide bag.
Okay.
It itself bursts because of the enzyme. This is what lysosome is.
Question was chilo hemophilia ni. So
achha.
Hemophilia jo dekhte discuss.
Hemophilia is a genetic disorder. We say that this is a X-linked recessive disorder. X-linked meaning is what? We know that male and female, males are having the chromosome XY and females are having XX. I'm talking about humans. Okay, XX in female and XY in male. So in the beginning, I would like to say here that we have, means males have two different chromosomes, reproductive, I mean sex chromosomes, these are called sex chromosomes, and female have XX. So it is the male who decides whether the next generation would be a son or a daughter. It doesn't mean that males are controlling over it, they cannot control, but it decides from the male, you know, chromosome combination. Anyways, it's the X chromosome linked recessive disorder. Recessive means it's the disorder which jump the generations. Recessive means it's a weak, means it is not expressed in all the generations. Okay, so it jumps, it there is a gap between the generations on expression. One more feature is that this hemophilia is a bleeding disorder. Actually, it's a bleeding disorder. Bleeding disorder means if there is a cut or injury in the cell or in any part of the body, the bleeding continues, is very tough to clot that part. This is a problem. It transmits. How it transmits? Where in this case the females are always carrier of the disease and males where it is expressed. Means the disturbing chromosome is carried by the female where it is not expressed there, but males where it is always expressed. Females also express, but it's very rare. I said it is X chromosome linked, means that females have two alternatives, because two eggs they have. So if one X is affected by hemophilia, so it is the carrier woman, and if both the X is affected, it is the hemophiliac woman, which is very rare. In case of male, what happens that we have only one X chromosome, and if it is affected, we are hemophiliac. Okay, so there are some calculations on the basis that we can even predict that if father is hemophiliac, mother is not, or mother is carrier, father is not. So on the basis of that, it's called period square. We can also predict to some extent that what would be the possibility that the next generation would be hemophiliac or not. Depends on that. We can, there's some calculations. So it's very easy calculations. Okay, some like, for example, suppose the female is carrier, then we're at X for hemophilia, and male is normal XY. So if we calculate it, we'll get that XHX means one carrier woman will get, and XHY, so one hemophiliac male we will get. Okay, so this is how we can to some extent predict the hemophilia. So hemophilia is a, you know, it's a it can inherit from generation to generation. It's called, it's a genetic disorder. That's the hemophilia.
খুব ভালোই হলো, অনেক ভালো করে শুনলাম আমরা হিমোফিলিয়া সম্বন্ধে। আচ্ছা, এরপরে দিব্যেন্দু স্যার যদি ম্যাট্রিক্স নিয়ে
খুব বেশি সাবজেক্টিভে সময় হবে না,
আচ্ছা
তো কিছু কোয়েশ্চেন্স
আচ্ছা
নিয়ে ডিসকাস হতে পারে। লাইক এরকম একটা এসেছিল, -1 -½ 3/2 দিস ইকুয়াল টু এ, তো ওর ভ্যালুটা এরকম চাই, এ স্কোয়ার এ কিউব আরো অনেক কোয়েশ্চেন পেয়েছি, লাইক 3 3 3 8/4 এর ভ্যালু কত, a = 1 1 8/100 এর ভ্যালু কত। আমরা নেক্সট সেশনগুলোতে কমপ্লেক্স ম্যাট্রিক্সের উপরে ডিসকাস করব, রো একেলান ফর্ম নিয়ে ডিসকাস করব, তা এখানটাতে একটু আসছি। আমাদের ইনফাইনাইট জিপি ওখানে ইনফাইনাইট বাইনোমিয়ালে পেয়েছিলাম, এখানে এটাকে তো আমরা এটাই লিখতে পারি, তো আই মাইনাস এ এর ভ্যালু i 1 0 0 1 -a -1 3/2 -½ দেন
1 1 0
আর হাফ -½ -3/2 হাফ। এবার ভ্যালুগুলো করে নাও, 2 -3/2 হাফ, এটাও হাফ, এটার ইনভার্স বের করবো আমরা, 2 -½ -3/2 হাফ। এবার ইনভার্স বের করতে কি করবো, এটা ডিটারমিনেন্টের ভ্যালুটা বের করে নেবো, এই দুটো প্রোডাক্ট হলো 1 মাইনাস এই দুটো প্রোডাক্ট হলো 3/4 1/4 এবার 1/4 কি হবে, এরা জায়গাটা এক্সচেঞ্জ করে নেবে, এখানে হাফ এখানে 2 এসেছে, এরাও জায়গা এক্সচেঞ্জ করে নেবে, -3/2 এখানে -½ কি হবে, এখানে প্লাস মাইনাস, তো মাইনাস হয়েছে অলরেডি, প্লাস এটা হলো। এবার কি করব, ট্রান্সপোজ করে নেব রো, এবার এটাকে সিম্পলিফাই করে কিছু আনসার পাওয়া যেতে পারে, বা অপশনটা দেখে যে আরো কতটা আমরা সিম্পলিফাই করব সেটা দেখব। আরো অনেকগুলো খুব ভালো ভালো কোয়েশ্চেন পেয়েছি, পরবর্তী সেশনে আমরা আরেকটু ভেতরে ডিসকাস করব, ডিসকাস করে ওই কোয়েশ্চেনগুলোকে আমরা সলভ করব। তো লাস্টে আরেকটা কোয়েশ্চেন তো হতেই পারে, লাইক ওই ওটা 3 3 3 গুলোকে তুলে নেব, স্কোয়ার। সেই মাল্টিপ্লিকেশন কলাম দিয়ে ফার্স্ট রো এটা থ্রি বাই থ্রি রয়েছে, তো ওয়ান ওয়ান প্লাস ওয়ান অ্যান্ড দেন আবার থ্রি
থ্রি থ্রি
এরকম করে আসছে। আবার থ্রি তুলে নেব, টোয়েন্টি সেভেন ওয়ান ওয়ান ওয়ান
ওয়ান ওয়ান ওয়ান।
এবার চাই কি এ টু দি পাওয়ার ফোর, ইজ এ স্কোয়ার ইন্টু এ স্কোয়ার, একটা এ স্কোয়ার কত এসেছে দিস টোয়েন্টি সেভেন ইন্টু দিস টোয়েন্টি সেভেন স্কোয়ার সেভেন টু নাইন, আবার মাল্টিপ্লাই করলাম সেই এটা ওই থ্রিগুলো ফিরে আসছে, তো আমাদের এখানে থামতে হবে কারণ এটা তো এ টু দ্য ফোরই চেয়েছে যে এর চেয়ে বেশি চাই সেভেন টু নাইন দিস এর ভ্যালু এ। আমরা এ ইকুয়াল টু ওয়ান ওয়ান দিস এটা পেয়েছি, এটা আরেকটা কোয়েশ্চেন ছিল এ টু দি পাওয়ার হান্ড্রেড এটা কি হবে। তো এটা তোমাদের জন্যই থাকছে, আমাদের আর টাইম পারমিট করছে না,
নেক্সট দিন আমরা রিলিজ স্টার্ট করব,
কমপ্লিট করছি।
ঠিক আছে, নমস্কার।
নমস্কার।